Welcome back. Okay. Let's see what we've got going on. One galaxy map. Clusters already conquered by the Reapers can be accessed by the Normandy stealth drive. Search these clusters for survivors, salvage, and valuable intel. Roger. Okay, so. We've got Promethean artifact. And Cerberus Lab. What I'm going to do is I'm going to aim to do the Cerberus Lab in this episode. But before I do that, I'm going to search the rest of these clusters. See what that nets us. Normandy is equipped with an improved scanning pulse that can detect objects of interest. Use this to uncover war assets, artifacts, intel and fuel as you fly around. Be aware, however, that each system pulse increases the chance that the Reapers will enter the system to investigate if Reapers enter the flee and when to. Okay, so basically we don't want to touch this one for a while. What we got here? Probably the best route to go is going to be this way. I wonder. Let's try here.
I found something.
Ooh, they didn't like that. Newell? Though it's one of the oldest entries in star charts, Newell has not been fully mapped. It's the largest body of an in the asteroid belt of the blue star Pluturus, not only large enough to maintain a spherical shape, but also massive enough to retain a noxious carbon and sulfur dioxides venting from many volcanoes as an atmosphere. Nonel is rabidly volcanic, and the source of great heat is also the source of the inordinate mass. Nonel is a secondary source of element zero, coalesced around a large chunk of Ezo ejected by a supernova billions of years ago. Surface conditions are extremely hazardous. In addition to the thin crust and numerous magma flows, wide stretches of landscape are coated with slippery ash from the cinders of the volcanoes. So which way? This way? Where are you? I'm coming to get you. There you are. What did we win? Anything? Ah. Spec Ops team and a division. Fantastic. Oh, that's even better. 100% assets recovered, so we haven't got to come back here. Let's try this. Okay, so let's try over here first. No. Okay.
Signal confirmed.
That's not a good sound. Kensal has a thin atmosphere of its carbon dioxide and methane. Its first geological survey were performed by the Batarians and suggested areas of great mineral wealth. Human mining concerns spent billions of credits hustling to distant system and sinking best bores in to claim the system for humanity, but Kensal had only average level of mineral wealth, valuable but hardly worth a rush and expense. Moderna, Australia and a small Mexican company hoping to strike it rich in their first extrasolar mining venture had to file for bankruptcy. Investigation revealed that the Batarian crew had deliberately falsified their surveys, hoping that it would encourage human rivals to interest in a costly boondoggle. While unethical, this was not technically illegal, and the Batarian government disavowed the personal actions of a few misguided patriots. The planet is still littered with the abandoned mining base, which is often used as a temporary meeting place for criminals. Awesome. Where are you, little thing? Oh, over here. There you go. What did we win? Credits. Okay, and let's keep going. Okay, there it is. So if we just pop out a second. And we pop in. That's not gonna work. It's going. Come on, give us a different entry in. And run away!
Faster than light jump successful.
Thank God. Okay, let's go over to Farnatia, I hope. Okay, wow, that's a big, big sum.
I found something.
Okay, what have we got? More fuel, fantastic. 50%. Jutamala is a small, broiling terrestrial world. Its thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and ethane is being steadily blown off by a powerful solar wind from the star Phanitia. The surface is scorching hot and mainly comprised of sulfur with deposits of copper. Its density is low enough to leave the world tightly locked to Phanitia. Alliance Defense Data Network notes that several ships have been spotted cruising near Jatiuma with transponders turned off while the Alliance patrols attempt pursuit of one of the unidentified vessels rehabilitated to FTL. Its trail was lost and then obscured by the light traced in the confusion signals of the... Oh, I'm not even going to attempt that one. It's one problem with sci-fi games. They come up with some... Well, I suppose sci-fi games and fantasy games. They come up with some right strange words. What do we want? Alliance frigate and... Alliance First Fleet. Now, run away!
Evasion successful.
Which means we can drop down to Calculus. Great, a planet place about maps. Okay. That's not good.
Signal confirmed.
Kohi is a terrestrial planet whose surface is mainly composed of aluminium with numerous deposits of calcium. Though it has enough mass to retain a dense atmosphere, Kohi is nearly a vacuum. This lack of atmosphere allows moderate to average temperature, but the difference between day and night are extreme. The surface of Kohi, sunward facing side, is usually covered by a haze of volatiles, mainly water vapor and carbon dioxide, which return into the ground form as a frost over the course of the long cold night. The Serta Foundation has established a research outpost on Kohi to investigate the native subterranean life of the planet, which shows incredible resistance to extremes of heat and cold. Let's see what we got. Might have missed. Oh no, we got some credits. 50.
Reapers okay. Eluded.
Let's try again. Come on. Where's the other one?
Faster than light jump successful.
Good for you.
Evasion successful.
go.
Reapers eluded.
Oh, it had to move me, didn't it? Come on. So, tight turn. No.
Faster than light jump successful.
What we need to do. Nope, that's not going to work either.
Evasion successful.
That's the problem. What I ideally need to do.
Reapers eluded. Faster than light jump successful.
There we go. Thank God for fuel. Right.
Evasion
so
successful.
We can now go here. And that should be most of it.
I found something.
Trebin is a modest terrestrial world with an atmosphere composed of nitrogen and argon. Its surface is mainly comprised of nickel with deposits of silver. Trebin's environment is relatively mild, but scarcity of water or similar enabling substances has prevented the development of any type of biosphere. Exogeny Corp recently performed a test impact of a single water ice comet into a surface, with the first step of a long-term plan to thicken at the atmosphere and produce water into the environment. A survey team on the surface monitoring the geological and meteorological effects of the test impact. Most of the water released is still in the form of atmospheric vapor. But thick clouds of banks have formed. They are very, very indication that this arid world will soon see the first rain. Survey team progress has been hampered by frequent mechanical or computer failures in their GPS satellites. That's not going well here. But what did we win? Credits. Fantastic. That's gonna set an alarm. How about you? Oh. Where's the last one? There you go. Where are they? So we can probably grab this fuel. Fantastic, and
faster than light jump successful.
Get out of there, and that's 100. Fantastic. Right, kite's nest. What do we have here? Okay, so there is another system around here, because you can do this. Okay, so we're down here, are we? Okay, I can live with that. I don't like the positioning of all this stuff.
Signal confirmed.
Fuel? Yep. 50% assets. And there's the other one. Edek is a brutally hot and wet garden world covered in mold and lichen analogues. It has many viruses and bacteria lethal to Batarian physiology. The homogeny colonized Edek early in its expansion, but few of the colonists wanted to stay. The result was a domination by a class of land slave owners. A small caliber of well-paid engineers and skilled labourers kept the planet's mechs and infrastructure from malfunctioning. The Alliance estimates put the planet's Batarian population at just over 6 million, but the number has likely fallen ever since the Reapers arrived. Awesome. So this is Batarian planet. They don't like me. And they gave me some credits. Awesome. And that's everything. Wow. That's sweet.
Evasion successful.
I know. Now let's see what's up. Heresy? Heresy? However you would like to pronounce that. Boop.
I found something.
Awesome. Karshana, the Batarian homeworld, is wrapped less in mystery than in outright lies. Batarian propaganda claims this world has 15 billion inhabitants and its economy that rivals the Asari. Although the legal slave trade does boost the Batarians' profits somewhat, Citadel sanctions have left a paper tiger of an empire. Don't know that phrase. That fights rivals through deniable terrorist actions rather than the wars of the heyday centuries ago. The Reapers will likely be the death blow for that empire. Almost no information has escaped Karshana since the Reapers destroyed the convoys, but Batarian refugees say that the resistance has created a bond among commoners. The new government can rise from the ashes. That bond may sustain a new Batarian society. Awesome. Again, Batarians don't like me. Probably not gonna like me sending a probe. Pillars of strength. Fantastic. That's good. And what are you at? 33. Fuel. Fantastic. And what we got here? Verush. Verush is a hydrogen helium gas giant named for an ancient Batarian monarch whose empire spanned continents. He had such penchant for mating that 0.6% of the modern Batarians claim their trace, their lineage to him. The planet's moons are named after his many recognised wives. The largest, Brara, concealed Prothean ruins that help Batarians develop FTL travel. It is a Batarian point of pride. Since the ruins were damaged by earthquakes, they had less information to go on than any other spacefaring species. The Reapers have destroyed all obvious military outposts in the Vernish orbit. The Batarians' notorious secrecy, however, may have allowed concealed subterranean facilities to survive on the moons. Yeah, no, it didn't quite say that, but, you know, I'm just running out of steam. Ooh, weapon upgrade kit. Not gonna knock that. Let's... 100% assets. 100, yep. We are done here. Exodus cluster. Let's have a look see. We're trying to avoid the actual mission one here. Let's see if there's any other systems here. Yes, there is. And that's a long way off. How's my fuel doing? Yay!
Signal confirmed.
Oh, awesome. Please say that's 320. Oh man, that's gonna blow. Tier is a compositionally similar to Earth. However, it lies over 4 AU from Asgard and possesses an atmosphere primarily composed of nitrogen and ethane. While a potential target of terraforming, the proximity of the shirtless sleeves habitable Terra Nova relegated Tier to a support role. Nearly 100 corporations, human and alien, constructed teleoperated mining, refining and manufacturing facilities across the planet. The Reapers immediately targeted these, seeking to cut off the Alliance's supply of hydrogen fuel cells. I wonder if that's an indication to what we're going to find here. Hydrogen fuel cells. But I definitely get the feeling they don't like me being here. What do we have here? Bohr is a hydrogen helium gas giant with over 90 moons. The light of the ionized hydrogen filtering through the upper cloud deck of sodium causes its striking coloration. The source of the ionization has not yet been confirmed, but Bohr's mass equal to 6 Jupiters and high temperature suggests that it may be a brown dwarf, a gas giant that has gained almost enough mass to be ignited into a small star. The Reapers destroyed Bohr's extensive Helium-3 infrastructure, although wreckage indicates that the 6th Fleet did not give up the planet without a fight. 6th Fleet. Are we going to find something 6th Fleet related? Nope, we just find the remains of a destroyed Reaper. Okay, we're doing well. Terra Nova was one of the Class 1 colonization prospects discovered by the first wave of the Alliance surveys in 2150. It was the second human extrasolar colony and the first beyond Charon's mass relay. It once boasted the highest population of any formally endorsed Alliance colony. But in recent years of Batarian attacks has caused many to emigrate. The name Exodus Cluster became all too apt. The Reapers landed on Terra Firma after a brief battle with the Alliance 6th Fleet. Aware it would lose, the fleet retreated in the hopes of meeting allies and retaking the planet. Intelligence indicates that the Reaper force is here. Here is light, and debate rages over whether or not it will try and liberate the planet, or if such an effort would prove fruitful if the Reapers sent reinforcements. So, whoever's here may be screwed. Definitely may be screwed. And we got the cruiser Shanghai. Okay,
Reapers so. Eluded. Faster than light jump successful.
Alright. Yeah, we do. Small terrestrial world with little to recommend it. Loki's one hemisphere is largely covered by ice and other by craggy ballistic highlands. The rough varied terrain suggests ancient cataclysm caused significant damage to the planet, reaching 6.5 AU at the perigee of 7.1 AU at apogee. Loki's unusual elliptical orbit reinforces the hypothesis. Beneath Loki's ice cap runs a naturally formed network of subterranean tunnels. These may have proven useful to the Alliance F forces in retreat. Nonetheless, any organics hidden here remain in peril as Loki's atmosphere is inhospitable and Reaper technology is very efficient. Okay, so we can get it, but that Reaper thing is right on my butt ski, so going to be interesting.
Evasion successful.
Wow, didn't expect that. So that's 100, that's 71, so I think there's two in here. Let's see. Okay, that's not going up.
I found something.
Ah, Zion. Is this the Matrix? Zion is a hydrogen helium gas giant, even larger than Jupiter. Despite its deep gravitational well and lethal radiation, it supports a small helium-3 mining industry. The reason is simple: as the only gas giant in Utopia system, it's the only local source of fuel for Eden Prime's power stations. Zion has 112 natural satellites, ranging from orbiting asteroids to the moon of Asphodel, which is large enough to retain a thick atmosphere. So this thing's big. Good to know. There you are. Another thing here, probably fuel. Yeah, that's fuel. So Utopia's done. 100, 100, 100. We are getting there. What we got in Anos Basin? Zip here, and again we're going to avoid this mission because this progresses the actual main storyline, but I'm going to investigate, see what we have around. Gamma Me, let's head there. Okay, so
signal confirmed.
Awesome. And you are a lot of fuel. Why not? It's not like we're going to be coming back. That's a lot of fuel. What do we have here? Pharos is an asteroid towed to the near of a B-class blue giant. Gamma Me to serve as a terrestrial military base in a system devoid of planets. A vast array of solar collectors absorb energy from the star and beam it to receptors near the tidally locked asteroid's terminator zone. Beneath the surface, dozens of particle accelerators generate antiprotons for starship fuel. The Reapers sent a substantial force to Ganymede's system, but found that the Taurians were capable and prepared to defend their Armada's fuel resource. Warning messages say that the Reapers are still present in the system, waiting reinforcements at present. Taurians can still refuel, but only because they committed forces here that could otherwise have defended Pavalon. Okay, so we found all the fuel. What did they leave on the planet? Taurian fleet. Awesome. So we've rescued people. Awesome. Castellellus? Castellus. Interesting.
I found something.
Good. Please be fuel. Yep, that's fantastic. 50. Let's play a hunch here. And that hunch is wrong. Just enough time. Degrees. A hospitable world to the dextro amino acid based life forms. This Turian colony was famous until recently for being the site of the bloodiest battle in the Turian history. During the Krogan rebellions, a warlord named Galgan Dal took the fight to Pavolan's home cluster, bombarding the modest defenders Digaris. When reinforcements came to intercept him, Dal's navy put their rear to Digaris so they could stray shots would hit the planet. The Taurians won despite this severe handicap. During countless fights, fighters and cruisers to take down the Krogan dreadnoughts. Today, the Taurian fleet holds Digaris in a stalemate. The Reapers, concentrating on Pavalon and elsewhere, sent a relatively light force to take the planet, which the Taurians repelled. The Taurians stand guard at Digaris, whilst Reapers travel throughout the system, destroying targets of opportunity until reinforcements arrive. Ooh, what am I doing? Getting carried away. Let's head down here. Come on. Where are you? There you go. Banner of the 1st Regiment. Banner of the 1st. Artifact. Fantastic. So that's 100.
Eluded.
So, if we jump this way... But we can do a manual fuel up. So if we pop out of here, that's 100. Fantastic. Which leaves this place, which is kind of my destination. Gets me where I'm going, which is nice. Same deal though. Okay, so we got to do this one on the way back. So let's go find the Cerberus lib. Drop in here. That's
signal confirmed.
Fantastic. Lena, cloaked, is a methane cloud hothouse planet. Its lack of metal-rich core and significant magnetosphere allows for an easy scan which reveals mining equipment on its surface. It can also be deduced that this mining occurred within the last 5 years. Any longer and the machines would have been worn down to nothing by the excessive heat and dust storms of hot ionizing stuff. Come on. What we got? Credits. Okay. 50%. There we go. There's the other one. That should be fuel. I'm good at this game. Right, let's do this then. Cerberus Lab. Sanctum is a proof of the old space adage, because it's a garden world doesn't mean it's a picnic. Freezing ice storms cover the poles and temperature zones, leaving a narrow strip of habitable land at the equator. Dry but windy, this area is home to Sanctum's minimal terrestrial planet life. The planet is yet to develop land-based animals, though invertebrates grow quite large in its plagiaxes. Mining referred to ice cracking at anywhere but the equator is common employment on Sanctum. The planet is rich of platinum and palladium deposits as well as boron, which is locally used in semiconductor doping. Doping? Carbon dioxide levels on Sanctum can reach 5,000 parts per million during thermal inversions. Travellers should carry a breathing mask at all times and consult. Piracy is at a 14 global high. Yeah, okay. Let's go for this. Let's have a bit of combat. Gee, I wonder who I'm gonna have. Yeah, I think those two. Right, so what have I got? I've got the Avenger, the Eagle, and the Hurricane. Yep. You have the N7 and the N7. And you have the N7 and the N7. That'll all do for now. If we pump these, no mods there, no mods. I don't really, well, maybe, oh. Fantastic. 5 points. Weapon damage, force power and duration. I'm not going to be... She's going to be doing that sort of stuff. 7, arms master. Power, yep. And I have none. Fantastic. Let's get it on!
Commander, I've got a hail from Admiral Hackett. Put him through, Lieutenant.
Shepard, we've uncovered a secret Cerberus lab, function unknown. We sent in a recon team, but they were forced to pull out before they got very far.
Any other intel?
We think they're using the facility to warehouse and study Reaper tech. We've been wondering how Cerberus is connected to the Reapers, and this might give us some answers.
We're on it.
Find out what Cerberus is doing and get me any Reaper tech samples you can, Commander. Hack it out.
Just gonna have a look around for stuff. Where is it? There you go. Personal log, C. Tavini. Finally here. Wow, the troops are here. Are really intense. No smiles. Ever. And suicide on capture orders. Seriously. And they're training interrogation. I start interrogating tomorrow. Can't wait. Okay. Let's just have a look-see around. Reload a bit. There's some credits. Before we do that objective, because I know that we have to repeat this a couple of times, I am just going to have a look around and see if there's anything else around here of interest. Because the last thing I want to do is start the next wave and... Same guy, interrogation successful, suicide on capture orders confirmed, Cerberus, my friend, obey, protect humanity at any cost. A little bit too loyal for my liking, should ask questions. There's some credits. Okay. I think it's time. Oh, what have I set to? Fantastic. There you are. So, containment bypass.
Well, that's weird looking. Guess we found it.
Got the sample.
Roger that. Meet you at the landing pad.
Okay, let's try going this way. Nope. All good so far. Okay. No one's rumbled yet.
Second sample located, Commander. Nav point updated.
Good work.
Where are we going? That way. Okay. So we've got to clear the way.
Eyes on the line.
Alright. Yep, stop swinging around. Oh, screw it.
Need to hold out until Cortez can pick us up.
Nothing like having your back to the wall.
Never said it would be easy.
Over yet.
I could do this all day.
Good, because we're going to have to. Where did that come from? Awesome. Where's the other guy? Come on. We can do this.
Commander, just stay focused and keep at it.
Fantastic. Okay, that'll get you moving. You ain't got anywhere to go, really.
Yeah,
got it.
Roger that.
Okay, so that should do you. So I'm going to have to think about raiding the ammo supply.
Keep the landing pad clear.
Roger.
Commander had to go dark side to shake him. Coming in hot. Be ready.
We're ready for extraction as soon as you can get here.
so close. Resume.
Commander, had to go dark side to shake him. Coming in hot, be ready.
We're ready for extraction as soon as you can get here. Extraction point. Ready for pickup.
Almost there.
Again, so close.
Commander, had to go dark side to shake him. Coming in hot. Be ready.
We're ready for extraction as soon as you can get here.
Let's head over this way then. You're going to be doing that. Yep.
We're at the extraction point. Ready for pickup. That time's a charm, huh?
Commander, we've got our best engineers looking at the Reaper tech you secured from that lab.
What was Cerberus doing with it?
We don't know yet, but whatever Cerberus is up to, it can't be good. Even if we can't determine its purpose, we've disrupted their experiments.
I doubt they'll just close up shop.
Agreed. We'll keep sending strikes against the facility. Good work, Commander.
And there we are. An N7 mission completed, which, as far as I recall, the N7 series of missions are...
Did you see the Citadel when we were there on leave? You'd never know there was a war on.
They'll know soon enough. All those refugees have to go somewhere.
The N7 series basically used the maps from the multiplayer, if I remember correctly. Which is kind of why you have this hold and extract and things like that. So that means 50%. There's got to be two in here. Let's try you.
I found something.
Yay! Watson is known in human media for two things, its spectacular tides brought on by a large moon and bureaucratic snafu over which Earth nation got to settle here first. Watson is a garden world, first discovered in 2165 CE, with credit claimed by the Chinese People Federation, the United North American States and the European Union. The system alliance brokered the infamous Rajivek Compromise, allowing limited colonization from each coalition in cities comprised of populations from each nation. Watson itself tends colder than Earth, with a temperature zone measuring about 30 degrees latitude in the direction from the equator. Its life does not easily map to Earth's evolutionary eras. Some islands may have species that resemble terrestrial placental mammals, others are overrun by arthropods. It's estimated that two or more generations of xenologists will be needed to properly classify all the species of the planet. Okay, so it has a lot of life forms. No. Come on. Where are you? Oh, there we go. Boof! Javelin missile launcher. 50. No. What about over here? No. Over here? There you go. There's the inception sound. So we're just pop around here. Yay, we have you.
Evasion successful.
So that's that. That's that. We should be able to make it to that location, pick it up, and use the mass relay to get the fudge out of Dodge.
Reapers eluded.
Like so. So that's 100. That's 100. We are doing well. That's probably going to be the next mission that I do. Recover Promethean artifact. So if we just head out here, exit, we turn to the camera, there we go. Thank you for watching, hope that you've enjoyed the video, and I will catch you on the next one.